Okay, girl. Hey, baby loves, welcome back to the Fiesta. If you're new here, my name is Keyshawna Dupuy. And if you're not, you're loyal. Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell below if you're interested in seeing weekly hair or skin product reviews, tips, tricks, and advice. Today, we are making an avocado and red onion deep conditioner. I don't know about y'all, but I don't know about the red onion. I'm nervous about it. I'm gonna do it because I'm very much intrigued. Ever since I tried the Cardi B avocado mask, I feel like I've been seeing some version of that mask or just some DIY avocado involved thing everywhere, all over social media, people talking about it. But I'm okay with that because ever since I did that mask, I learned how much my hair loves avocado. You guys seen it yourself. My hair literally drops down in curls whenever that mask touches it. And I know it's from that avocado. When I seen this mask, I actually seen it posted by Healthy Hair Journey on Instagram. I'm gonna put their tag below. The ingredients caught my attention very quickly, so let's talk about them. It's an avocado, one banana, a red onion, half a red onion, a good chunk of ginger, another one that I was like, okay, and some plain yogurt, low fat. They had non-fat, this is low fat. I don't know how it's gonna go. I'm really praying that it doesn't smell horrible, but that's why I'm here, to try it. Let's do it. Before we jump into making the mask, I do want to talk about the benefits of each ingredient, just that we have an idea of what the goal would be. So avocados are actually extremely moisturizing and nourishing because they contain natural oils. It's also really rich in vitamins that helps the hair look healthy, shinier, and helps your scalp overall. One of the main vitamins that it does contain that's great for hair is biotin. Bananas actually contain silica. It's supposed to make your hair stronger and thicker. Some people even say that bananas help heal flaky and dry scalp, which would then get rid of any dandruff type symptoms. The scary red onion. Supposedly, what I'm hearing is that when added to hair and your scalp, onion juice can actually provide extra sulfur, which would then prevent hair loss and promote hair growth. Mainly, I'm seeing a lot of talk about hair loss prevention, and if that's the case, that's fire. Now, the ginger is actually supposed to help increase the blood flow in your scalp, so scalp circulation. And when it does that, it stimulates the hair follicles and helps with hair growth as well. Last but not least, the yogurt. The proteins in this is actually believed to help promote healthier and stronger hair. And some people say that it can actually help cleanse the scalp, which would then lead to hair follicle growth, because you know, if you want hair growth, you have to prioritize a healthy scalp. We are going to make sure we blend this, because if I learned anything about a DIY avocado situation, it's pretty lumpy. It could take a minute to get out of your hair. So we're gonna make sure we blend the heck out of it, because I don't want any remaining chunks of any of this stuff. I'm kind of nervous because I'm using it as a deep conditioner. When I did the Cardi B one, I did it as a mask pre-poo situation before shampooing. This time it said deep conditioner, so I wanted to use it after shampooing, and I'm just hoping for the best at this point. All right, let's go make this deep conditioner.
Okay, so here we go.
I wish y'all could see how quick I peeled this onion, because I refuse to start the tears and the crying. So this has everything. I'm nervous that I should have gotten another avocado or the really big one, but it is what it is. This is what we have. Hopefully the yogurt and the banana and avocado all together is enough to smooth it out. We have fully blended our mask. It's very smooth. It made a lot, which is great because I like to really pack it onto my hair, and I have a lot of that, thank God. I made sure to put the blender on high at first, and then when I seen that it looked smooth is when I switched it to smoothie to make sure it was extra smooth. Cause like I said, I want this to be an easy washout process. It smells disgusting, as expected. It has some interesting ingredients mixing with each other right now. But we're gonna just jump right into applying it to my hair. I don't know, I actually have really good faith in this. It's a weird texture. I'm gonna get my water bottle because I do think that my hair should be soaked, because I would usually apply this in the shower. The ginger is so strong. This is grainy almost. I can see the little, ooh, okay, but my hair liking it. I definitely would put more avocado. So either get two of the little black one I used or get one large, really large avocado. Something in this is making my eyes slightly burn, like a slight tingle. Nothing I can't deal with, it's just still there, which is annoying. Very grainy. My hair is liking it though. I ain't mad. You see how this look? So we're doing this versus this. My eyes are definitely burning right now. I think it's the onion mixed with the ginger that has my eyes burning. And if it doesn't stop in a little, that would automatically make this not approved because there are so many other versions of this that can be done that would give you the same benefits without irritating so much. But we'll see, hopefully it goes away soon. This is slightly messy, by the way, so definitely do it in the shower. This texture, oh my God. I'm really praying that this isn't super hard to get out of my hair. As of right now, based on the experience, I don't like the texture. My hair is enjoying itself. It's definitely taking well to it. However, my hair has taken better to other things. And overall, the eye irritation is a big problem. So because of that, right now, this is not approved. I'm gonna continue though. Yeah, I don't know y'all. I'm determined. I rinsed my eyes out and I'm still trying to finish this just for you guys because honestly there is a chance that it could be a good mask. It's just the onion has to go because it burns. But this is how my hair looks. You can see the curls trying to pop out. My eyes are okay right now, so I am gonna put on my heat cap and try my best to wait it out. Just a little longer, maybe like 15 minutes. I sat with it for about 20 minutes sitting in my hair. My hair feels soft. Feels really soft, actually. It has like a slight coolness right now in my scalp. That feels good. Okay, curls. I love how soft my roots feel because the heat was hitting it more directly from the cap. This feels really nice. All right, I'm gonna go wash it out and pray that all this graininess is able to come out. I wanted to show you guys really quickly what's happening as I'm washing it out. It's so grainy that it is not coming out easy. So I'm about to basically rewash my hair. My curls look good. My hair looks shiny and healthy, but it actually doesn't feel that soft at all. So it's not approved. It's not horrible, but this is definitely not approved. I would hands down rather the Cardi B hair mask. This burned my eyes. My hair is grainy. I just, the thing is, I actually have faith that in terms of the properties, like it could really be good for hair strength and hair loss. I'm gonna go wash my hair. If you made it this far, I hope you already liked and subscribed because I don't know what you're waiting for. I thought I was done, but I also just wanna say the apartment smells like onions. I had to open the window. It's still in my hair. I re-shampooed, conditioned, and it's still there. It is not approved. If you have any questions about my experience, if you have any recommendations of what I could do differently, that'd be very helpful. But otherwise, if you have any product requests or video suggestions, go ahead and comment them below or DM me on Instagram. And if your idea is selected, you will get a shout out. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be back soon. Ciao.